Welcome to Greenberg News with your host, Brian Greenberg, and WNJC 1360 AM with a special holiday program. It is the holidays. They are finally here. Hope Santa gives you what you've always wanted or what you would like. And I hope your New Year's turns out to be a wonderful New Year's. I know the pressure is on to achieve all that, but we have some quality, valuable talent here to guide us and who has an expertise in an area I had no knowledge of. So even I have learned something today. So anyway, we have with us to kick off our program Valerie Weber, who has been painting the tri-state region with her permanent cosmetic talent for over a decade. Valerie, well-seasoned permanent makeup specialist with a background in art, professional makeup artistry, and clinical care, with over 15 years devoted to deepening her knowledge and abilities to change the lives she encounters through permanent cosmetic arts. Valerie, a lifetime SPCP, not like SPCA, but SPCP, Society of Permanent Cosmetics. I got that right. I get a star. She's the owner of the award-winning and founder of Dermographics Permanent Cosmetic Studio in Doylestown, Pennsylvania.
Yes.
I got that right. Mm-hmm. Hey, every now and then we do. She's a permanent cosmetic instructor, subject matter, and highly regarded speaker. Not just the regarded, but clearly highly regarded. Sought out for clients from all over the nation and abroad for her techniques. Cutting edge. Wow. And on Greenberg News, I think she made a mistake and made a wrong turn and wound up here. But we'll find that out. Valerie, welcome to Greenberg News.
Good morning. Welcome. I'm so happy to be here.
It's our pleasure. I mean, this is... You know, I had no knowledge. I always thought, like, when I ran across Valerie on LinkedIn, and she's talking about, and the bio is talking about, you know, tattoo or permanent, you know, cosmetic tattooing. I'm thinking, I guess she does ink. So I guess she's a tattoo artist. Just, you know, have balm on your arm, and that's how it works. But clearly, this is a whole different venue than the guy who works in some CD shop and, you know, with dirt all everywhere and, you know, guys dripping cigarettes and all
that
stuff.
We're absolutely different.
Absolutely. I'm glad you're absolutely different. So tell me briefly about what it is you guys do.
Well, I do want to say that a lot of tattoo shops are top-notch and very clean. We, you know, I don't want to say that they're not, but we are.
Never.
We certainly are different. We're cleaner.
You wash your hands there regularly, at least once, twice a day, right?
Perhaps.
If it, depending on the time of the year.
We usually have no skin left by the day's end.
No skin left. Mm-hmm. Ooh, the bare flesh is what's working on you
just
by
imagine.
5 o'clock at night. So the trick is you need to get there early so that you can have real flesh on you.
So you can have a, yeah, exactly.
That's a good thing to know, just FYI.
So, I mean, what we specialize in is, you know, cosmetic tattooing. It is tattooing. There's nothing different in the sense of our process. We're still using needles, clean needles, of course.
Needles.
We're still using needles
to
place pigment in the skin. And there's so many different reasons to do this for people. So I'll be happy to elaborate on a few of them because, you know, there's so much that we do. So we can talk about a few of
them. Actually, we were chatting before the show and you came up with one of the techniques you use. That not only it's a great technique, but as a New Year's resolution, it will save you time and it'll save you money.
Yeah,
completely. Tell our listeners. I mean, and you can benefit from Valerie's handicraft.
Yeah, I think the average. I actually did a survey for years. Client would come in, we would consult, and they would be talking about eyebrows and how long it takes them to put on eyebrows. I got as little as 5 to 8 minutes in the morning to 45 minutes.
45 minutes
every 45
day.
45 minutes. I often
day,
wondered.
A woman, and mostly women. There's some men now, too, I gather, who do this.
Yeah, mostly women.
Okay.
But yeah,
okay,
there's
a few. Just so we clarify, because it takes me about 20 minutes. So I just want to make sure I'm not alone. But yes.
So the general idea is, you know, nowadays people are really focusing. Eyebrows are trending, especially, you know, the last couple years. But eyebrows really make the face look more youthful. So women naturally put this on. It's something we're born with. It's not like lipstick. It's not like eyeliner. You know, it's something we're born with. So when people don't have it at all or have enough of it, they feel the need to enhance it. Anyhow, 25 minutes is the average.
So every
the average day, amount of time.
Every day, a woman, of course, will not go outside unless everything is perfect. If she cares clearly about her, you know, her appearance.
I have women that won't go to the mailbox without eyebrows.
Wow. Okay, because you never know who you'll meet when you, you know, go get your mail. So you want to, you always want to be on your game. So I get that.
Your eyebrow game.
Eyebrow, absolutely. Oh my God, she's with her bros. I'm out of here. It's you know, it could be like the mailman, you know, and all that. So all right. So this is clearly a need. So what does Dermaflex?
Dermographics.
Dermographics. I knew that wasn't right. Dermographics do to address the eyebrow crisis.
Cosmetic tattooing has many, many different sort of techniques, you know, under its umbrella. So there are some people who just need a little bit of color, and we're basically putting a background color behind, you know, on the skin to give them definition and shape. But there's a really, really special technique that we do called microblading, also known as hair strokes or feathering technique. But the microblading technique is an super realistic, a hyper realistic version of hair strokes. So we're actually able to create hair in the eyebrow area, the appearance of hair. Is it
real hair or it's like AstroTurf?
No, it neither.
Neither.
It's definitely tattooed to look like hair.
Wow.
The significance between microblading and regular tattooing is that it's the layer of skin that we're in. We're tattooing more shallow, so it gives a more crisp, true appearance, and it really, really looks three-dimensional. I have alopecia clients. I think I sent you some pictures of
yes,
people.
You did. That were frightening.
Did you think they had hair?
No. I mean, it was. I was frightened just to look at them to begin with. I was afraid of what kind of horror pictures is Valerie sending me.
But well, what did you think of the after pictures?
It's really remarkable. I mean, it's really, I could look at them. I had to cover up part of the screen for the people before because I get frightened easily.
I love those people. I empathize with them. Nice people. They, you know, it's an autoimmune disorder where, you know, their body fights against the hair follicles, and it can be in, you know, certain areas, just like eyebrows or patches of their body, or could take over the entire body. So having this procedure done can really, really really impact somebody's life. But we talked about saving time and money.
Yes. And so how does that happen?
Well, when you have your eyebrows tattooed by me or my staff, you know, yes, we take an exceptional amount of time to create this for you. It's not like you just lay down on a table and we go to town on your face. We talk about it, we design it.
You have a party and all that.
Yeah, tattoo party. Yes. We design it, and it's a very, very strategic process in getting you the proper shape, proper color. You know, we like to meet with each client and make sure that they're getting what they want. You know, we're not going to force them into something. So we understand that people get nervous before they do this. So we walk them through it every step of the way, guide them in the right choices. But the general goal is just to give them something that's long lasting that they can save 25 minutes a day.
Wow. So now when you do this, are they able to see in advance, like through computers or something, like how they'll look on it?
There is a program. We don't use it all the time, but there is a program that we could use to sort of generate that. It doesn't really give the hair stroke look, just a shape, but we draw on. I have a special tool that.
Yeah, like a magic marker kind of thing.
No, it's actually like this little razor fine tool that allows me to draw hairs on their skin, so I can actually show them what it'll look like.
So okay, so they'll get a sense. So it's not like they're closing their eyes. By the way, are they awake during the surgery?
Yeah,
okay.
And they're numb.
Okay, well, hopefully they're numb. That would be kind of if
they're
wincing.
Awake, they're numb. Yeah, yeah, their eyes are closed.
If they're wincing, yeah, and they can't open their eyes. Then yeah. They're not, what happens if they open their eye? That
will mess up. No, nothing happens if they open.
You don't
their
scotch
eye.
Tape their eyes to make sure they don't
duct tape.
Duct tape. Yeah, that is more
tape.
Effective.
That's the best.
Because I was in Mexico where they used duct tape to secure the, you know, the zip line. I felt it works.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, it really.
Cool.
That's why you're still here.
Absolutely. And I'll never go back to Mexico again, or at least go in a zip line there. Be careful. So,
but you will buy duct tape.
I will buy duct tape because I stand by it. And clearly you do as well. So here's my question to you. And I don't know if this analogy works or not, but hopefully it will. So for instance, men's fashion, shirts, collar sizes change. So right now, let's see, it's the thin collar is in.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say next year the wide collar is out. So my point is, in this analogy, let's say you gave somebody thin eyebrows. Let's say, for instance, next year, wide eyebrows are in or whatever.
Wide eyebrows are in.
Okay, so let's say it's wide now, and next year thin comes back, or 5 years from now.
Yeah, so the bottom line is...
Can you use like an eraser? Yeah.
No, we just don't do it.
You don't do what?
No, we just won't tattoo a very thick eyebrow. See, the best thing to do is to find the middle of the road, the happy medium. natural.
But this is permanent.
Find
obviously.
A natural
See,
look.
Yes, you can't really modify it because otherwise, I mean,
you can, but it's difficult to do. And so,
what's the point?
Prudent choices have everything to do with
right.
this process. So,
it's better then that you should. This is your one and done. Is my point. How long does it last, by the way?
No, you're not one and done. With microblading specifically, that
right.
particular technique, since we're not placing the pigment too deep in the skin, it doesn't tend to hang around too long. Permanent cosmetics in general are sort of the process was designed around the aging body. So as you age, you know, these tattoos, they fade. They may not, you know, hang around more than 5 years. So when you decide to go get it touched up, you know, your technician can just make it, you know,
can
a different
just like
color
a magic
or shape
marker
it.
Just do that, and they need a little more than that.
It seems that you do that now.
I think I've been very effective.
You need to come see me.
You think really? It's because I find it. You know, sometimes it can take like a minute or two. I just draw, but if I don't have a steady hand, it's the problem, and it looks like I got struck by lightning.
Yet another reason people come and see us: their arthritic conditions, their
Ooh.
Physical disabilities, to not be able to wear makeup, poor vision, glasses. You know, there's a lot of
wait because
reasons.
Of eyeglasses you need
you got to put the glasses on to see yourself in the mirror and
yes.
then get in the way of drawing where you need to draw, so people have to take them on, especially eyeliner.
Oh so they can't right. see it, so they're putting their eyebrow like in the middle of their forehead or something.
Yeah, they actually make a special pair of eyeglasses you can buy where you can sort of move one lens out of the way. One lens is in place. It allows you to draw your makeup on.
Dude,
yeah, who wants to go through
like
that
a problem? So it's I wouldn't want to do that. So okay. So now, it's a great idea, and this is so. What? How long does the process take? You just go into your studio and.
Well, we meet with everyone for a consultation. Okay. We want to make sure everyone's a good candidate. You know, not everybody that strolls through the door is a good fit.
What,
so,
like what would not be considered a good fit?
Good question. There's a lot
Every
of things
now and
medically.
Then we come up with a couple.
You know, we work with a lot of cancer patients, cancer survivors. You know,
right.
sometimes if somebody's on chemotherapy, they really need to check with their, you know, oncologist or prescribing physician to make sure that they're in good enough health to get something like this done. We are opening the skin. Somebody who's on certain medications may not be able to get this done quickly. They may have to, you know, be weaned off of a medicine.
Mm.
You know, I can't, you know, I'm not a physician, so I can't tell them this. They sort of have
you can
to,
sort
you
of
know.
Pretend like you're one. You know, and talk in an authoritative
When I wear the
voice.
Lab coat, it works.
Exactly. An authoritative voice, and you get the little thing around your neck, and, you know, and you're good to go.
Yeah. So, yeah. You know, there are a few people who aren't good candidates for hair strokes. You know, maybe somebody who has a lot of pigmentation spots, sunspots, or, you know, specifically around the eyebrow area. Maybe they have excessively oily skin or, you know, scarring. Scars are normal, by the way.
Okay.
We work with that all the time. I don't, you know, not
you can
any
fix
scar.
Scars.
I have certain scars.
Okay.
Certain scars. So, again, you can see why an in-person consult makes sense.
Evaluate
clearly. The skin.
Well, I don't think you would
right.
do it on the phone.
No.
It looks good.
Some people may, actually.
Really?
Yeah, some people take walk-ins. And I'm not saying that's bad. It's just not my preference. I've just seen so many things over 15 years that, I don't want to waste anyone's time. You know, we want to work with you if you're
You want to do
fit.
It right, obviously, and you
right.
take care. You know, just want to be, you know, just slop something on.
Right.
Well, I'm curious. You were mentioning, let's say, given this cancer, you know, someone's going under chemotherapy and, you know, they cease, and then oftentimes their hair will grow back.
Right.
So they may not be a good candidate either, I gather, because if they might want to do something permanent and then their eyebrows grow back, wouldn't that be an issue?
No, actually, as a specialist of eyebrows, one thing I can tell you is where we're placing the eyebrows would be where they would naturally grow. We may make it in a better shape.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe, you know, if they're growing their hair back, you know, after chemotherapy and eyebrows start to sprout and they're growing, they should be growing in the general tattooed area. Anything that's outside would be like, you know, a normal eyebrow maintenance, like an eyebrow wax or something. That's fine. So long as it's not being tattooed excessively high or low from where the existing
then
brow
you have,
is.
You have double eyebrows. That would be a problem.
That would be a problem.
Yes. You would not be.
Pictures. Pictures help. You know, sometimes clients, here's what I looked like.
Gotcha.
I actually am working with a woman right now who is coming to see me because she's getting ready to go into chemotherapy. Her oncologist explained that the type of chemotherapy was going to be the type that she may lose a lot or all of her hair.
Ooh.
And so she wants to preserve the shape now. So we are going in and doing some microblading for her before she gets the chemotherapy. That way it's not such a shock to her when they fall out, and at least she'll have something as she goes through the treatment.
And this way, that's great planning. Whereas another facility, there's not that many facilities in general that do what you do. Is that correct?
Right. But it is a specialty form of tattooing.
Right.
Sure.
But someone may have gone to somewhere else and they just sort of, you know, again, it's about the time and the preparation that you take to make sure that you plan accordingly and all that. So
absolutely.
So let's say, given this client, let's say if her hair does come back, it won't impact negatively upon the work that you did.
Absolutely not. We wouldn't want, especially for something as traumatic as cancer, you know, we wouldn't want to steer somebody down the wrong path.
Right, right.
Yeah.
But if someone came along and just shaved off somebody's eyebrows because it was a joke, you would, you're okay with that.
Well, you know, hopefully somebody doesn't do that, but yeah. Exactly. And we have people that pull their hair out as well. There's a condition called trichotillomania. We have a lot of...
Oh, with stress.
Stress-induced, you know, these clients, you know, again, scalp issues, you know, they're pulling hair out from various areas. But a lot of times it's eyelashes and eyebrows. And so, we can restore
that
for them.
The Intern. There was a guy. Did you ever see the movie The Intern?
I feel like it's been so long. I don't remember.
That's with, what's his name? Vince Vaughn and Dennis Wilson whatever Wilson is. I forget. And there was a guy in the movie that he was stressed and he would pull out his eyebrows. So his eyebrows were all bare. And then, of course, someone just used some makeup, you know, to cover up for that. So people do. There are people like that then.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. Oof. Yeah. Not a good thing. But by the way, this is something unrelated. I don't know if it's what you do, but I've always been curious about it. Botox. What's the deal with Botox?
Botox actually is a wonderful thing. I've had it done a few times. And
for
it.
What do you need Botox for?
And that's why you're asking me.
And that's why I'm asking. There you go.
So
you used to have a hairy a beard and a mustache. I'm sorry.
Yeah. I use Botox because I don't want those frown lines. I don't want those.
Turn your frown upside down. You ever heard that?
Absolutely. So it impacts the eyebrow area, the forehead area.
Yeah, right.
You know, people get it for their sweat glands too.
So they don't sweat?
Yeah.
What's wrong with sweating? Is that a normal human condition?
Maybe I think there's some people that have like excessive sweating. You can get Botox done now for that.
Oh my God! Mm-hmm. So, then that means you blow up because your liquid doesn't leave your body and
I'm not sure.
And then all of a sudden you implode. You know, it just become a blimp. So I don't think that's a good deal. I wouldn't recommend doing that.
Yeah.
So it's all right. So there is a. I always thought the concept of injecting. Poison, right?
It isn't. It's a purified protein. I actually went to Allergan's seminar for Botox.
I guess you would know a little more than me.
And it's an incredible drug that they're using to paralyze muscle temporarily to prevent creasing in the skin. It's like if you bent a paper clip back and forth several times, it gets that crease in it and you can't get rid of it. Well, that's what happens when we age, when you're constantly making expressions.
Well, people should not be sad. if you were happy, you would exercise the face.
Yeah, they should be teaching happiness instead of.
Well, it's very simple. It's not teach. It's just an attitude, and it's being miserable. It's like the people whose faces, people are nasty, like their face droops.
Yeah.
And you can do all you want. And then when, even if you fix it, it's still a droop that's pointed up. So it still doesn't work.
Well, I found in my line of work, Botox can be a plus and it can also be a minus. There's times people have eyebrow asymmetries just based on where their own muscle tissue and bone structure lies. And so having a Botox injection, the specialist might be able to place their eyebrows in a more symmetric position. And then when we tattoo them, you know, it aids in that look. But when the Botox wears off, they could be back to the asymmetry again.
Right.
So,
how long does Botox last, by the way, since you mentioned
3 to 6 months, I'm pretty sure.
You gotta keep getting. Mm-hmm. So it's not poison then?
I'm not a, you know, it's not supposed to be. And I do believe the studies. I do believe the studies. I'm not a specialist in Botox.
It had the little skull and crossbone on it. And it, other than that, it didn't seem like it was bad.
Yeah, the needle itself has that on it, right? Yeah.
Exactly. So I'm just worried. I guess I ignored it because, you know.
I think that if it were, I don't think a number of board certified plastic surgeons well known throughout the nation and worldwide, I don't think they would use it.
No, you sure? Because doctors today, you know, they're desperate for money.
No, I wouldn't get it done. I got it done. And I don't do lots of cosmetic stuff. You know, I believe in aging gracefully, you know, you should enhance. I wouldn't do it if I was scared of it. I think it's safe. I really do.
So you think I need Botox? I mean, that's the, that's, you know, because all the creases.
Doesn't hurt to try.
I don't know. I don't like to put any needles in my face. And I think about that. So now you're telling me I need it. Is that what you're telling me now?
You need it.
I need it. You need it. I appreciate it.
You need to try it. You need to see the difference. You need to say, wow, it does make a difference. And then you'll know you need.
So you're telling me I need it. Thank you. I was way up here.
Should I leave now?
If you can scrape me off the floor. I thought I'm flying high and she just shot me here. She's so nice and she has the sharpest of daggers. I never saw anybody slice anybody up.
It's actually a needle. Yeah, it's okay. The sharpest of needles.
Yes, and you used the sharpest of needles to cut me down to like below the floor. Oh my!
It's actually above the above the cheekbones.
Not the way you use that needle. That needle, there's nothing left of me. Thank you very much,
boy.
Valerie. I'm telling you, you're a real sweetheart, Valerie. Go try her dermographic. She'll cut you down to size.
And we'll build you back up, just like the military.
Is that what it is? Oh, I see.
Break it down, build you back up.
So this is all about getting me to come in here to say that if I don't use it, I'm a walking wreck.
No, you don't need Botox. You should really just try it just because it's awesome.
But how about I always, looking like, always.
You do eat processed food, don't you?
Never. I live on the farm.
Vegan?
I eat grass daily.
You eat grass, okay.
Literally.
Because if you eat that stuff, you can definitely get Botox and have no fears whatsoever.
Oh, wow. Because it's eating grass all the time, you're saying?
No. If you eat processed food.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So processed food is good
for you. I think
it's
worse. No, I think it's worse than having Botox.
Oh, really?
Because, an opinion.
I don't know. I mean, chemicals are good. The grass has some chemicals in it, so that it doesn't get, weeds and all. I mean, other than that, it seems to taste fine. So I don't know if I'm, I'm not ready to do it. No, I have a little bit of process, but is bacon considered processed?
Well, when you're
ready,
just call me. I'll hold your hand.
We will?
Can go together.
Yeah.
And I'll make sure that you're okay.
And then you'll slice off my hand. That'll be the end of it. I'll be now a cripple, thanks to you. Never mind. I'm telling you, Valerie. I'm glad there's a desk between us here. It's just because we're having.
Thanks a lot.
You're the one that's chopped me to shreds here. Oh, and I wanted to ask you. I was thinking about with Botox. That was a Freudian slip. Nicole Kidman.
Yes.
The actress.
Yeah.
And like she now has, she's like a zombie because she can't move any facial muscles.
Give her 3 to 6 months when it wears off. She'll be back to normal.
No, I think she overdosed is the problem.
Yeah, she might. A lot of them do. A lot of people do. Yeah, but there is such a thing as bodily dysmorphic disorder. Taking things too far. We've all heard of that.
Right. Well, that's particularly
in Hollywood. They always have to, I guess, be in competition with the next new young person who doesn't need Botox that's doing better than them. So
right. But one thing that's bizarre about that is that you would think in Hollywood, where they got more money than God there, that they would get somebody who knows what they're doing. So
look at Michael Jackson.
Of course. Exactly. That's my point. You would think that because he did literally have more money than God. It was a leverage buyout. It wasn't even leverage. He just bought out God a few years before he died. I think God didn't like it. That's why he smote him.
Yeah.
But smited him or whatever. But I'm saying is that they go that graphic, but I guess it's – well, he was way out there. But I'm just saying, but people who did normal, adaption in their body, that they can look so wretched, as a result. But you don't do any of that stuff.
No. Okay. It's so important the way people look when they leave. Our goal is to make people look natural.
So let's kind of get into the bigger picture. We've kind of addressed some of the fun stuff with the New Year's Eve tips and all. The value of your services really comes into play, and where people are just, you've changed lives by the work you do.
Yeah.
Tell us about that.
Well, there's so many different things. Changing lives. People are, it's deeper than saving time and deeper than saving money. It's really about giving people confidence.
Mm-hmm.
Not to say they didn't have any at all when they walked through the door, but I think it really gives them a new sense of confidence to where they really just feel much better about themselves. A lot of people can draw eyebrows on. There may be somebody listening to this who thinks it only takes me 5 seconds to draw my eyebrows on. But the key is, does it smear off during the day? Aren't you having to reapply it? What about when you go swimming or you work out at the gym? Maybe you can't get to the gym because you're spending time drawing on your eyebrows.
Right, exactly. You know? That all can work again. But I want to get into the other stuff that you do, where not just the eyebrow. The eyebrow thing, I think we've nailed that.
Yeah, okay.
So to speak.
So you want to go deeper.
I want to go deeper into all the other services. services that you do, the other types of, you enhance and just totally be, people had, let's see, was it rosacea? Is that a, let's talk about rosacea. That's a big thing. Yeah. No, you don't do that? Never mind.
No, rosacea is, you know, a skin type that we encounter when we're doing other services. But, you know, we manage that, no problem.
So let me ask you then, what is a common flaw where you go in and fix up?
Well,
besides
besides besides eyebrows, there's a number of different things we do. I'm going to touch on a couple of different things briefly, and then I think one big thing people may want to hear about is trichopigmentation.
Of course,
trichopigmentation is pretty big. Eyeliner is a big one. Lip color, tattooing scars for trauma victims. Areola tattooing for breast cancer survivors. That's another big one. But I did mention a little bit earlier about trichopigmentation. We started to talk a little bit about hair loss, but we kind of honed in on eyebrows. But hair loss, like male pattern baldness,
yes,
alopecia, trichotillomania, you know, we started to talk about the different reasons that people experience hair loss, and having a treatment like trichopigmentation can restore hair follicles in the scalp area. And I'll go into that a little bit more detail.
Let's clarify, because I'm a guy.
Sure.
And, you know, guys lose hair.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just all worry about that. So you hear, like, you turn on the TV, they have those infomercials. Some guy, you know, puts a lawn on your head and it looks great. So maybe not so great. Especially when you have to.
Sounds fabulous.
You know, AstroTurf, I think they call it. So in lieu of that, you have another process that creates the same effect. A better effect than having AstroTurf on your head.
You know, I don't think there's ever a replacement for the real thing.
Okay.
You know, in all honesty, I don't want to steer or mislead anybody in any particular direction.
You can do that. That's okay.
What we do is we create, when you're lacking hair follicles, you're seeing the white scalp or the very pale scalp. And a lot of guys are, you know, forced to wearing a hat every day. They're using products like, they're using products to conceal it, you know, whether it's, a topical fiber or a spray or, considering hair transplants. But the biggest thing is a lot of people who've undergone hair transplant surgery have been left with scarring.
Mm-hmm.
There are procedures nowadays where the scarring is minimal or better, but there's still thousands, tens of thousands of people who have been left with hair transplant scars, and we can help them conceal those scars.
If someone has, I guess it measures how deep the scar is and all that. If like you had like Scarface or something, like Al Capone.
Scars on their head from the hair transplants. Okay. They usually go from ear to ear in the back of the scalp.
Ew. Sounds
painful. And there can be several of them. Follicle unit extraction scars are small, round scars throughout the scalp area, where a linear scar is usually a straight line from ear to ear. And there, like I said, there could be 3-4 scars depending on how many transplants. It's the harvest area. So the surgeon usually goes in, he harvests hair follicles and transplants them usually to the crown, the vertex, the front scalp to recreate a fuller, more dense, area of hair for the client, the patient. And what happens is over time, they're no longer candidates for hair transplant. There comes a point where transplanting these hair follicles, you've run out of donor hair.
Right.
So they can't anymore.
And holes in your head to plant them, I guess.
Now they have scars. Right. They don't have enough hair to conceal the scars. Sometimes the hair transplant itself may not take where they've, hoped for
I'm
it to take.
I'm cringing here.
And so
I feel the pain.
We give them
really
supplemental color.
Here. Yes.
The supplement, the follicles that we're putting in, they're not actually follicles. It's pigment. We're not tattooing, though. Trichopigmentation is a special technique. It was developed in Italy, and the pigment goes very shallow in the scalp. The analogy I give my clients is, if you were to stand behind a frosted plate of glass very close to it, you could see the silhouette very clearly. If you were to stand 10 feet back, your silhouette becomes very blurred. You can't really make it out. So the deeper we place the pigment, the worse the effect is. The closer to the scalp, the surface, the more crystal clear it is. So one of the things is the placement. The type of equipment we're using is not a tattoo machine. It's made just for the scalp. So this particular trichopigmentation procedure is something I do. I'm actually one of the only technicians in the United States that provide this particular service. There is scalp tattooing. I do not do that. scalp tattooing or scalp micropigmentation, SMP, some people call it. That is not what I do. I do trichopigmentation, and the only other people in the United States that do it are hair surgeons.
Mm.
So
how did you acquire this unique skill that no one else does?
I actually got lucky. I was investigating it. I saw a lot of these scalp pigmentation places, and I've done scalp tattooing, you know, for years. And I thought, well, how is this different from what we already do? You know, what's the big deal? So I looked into it. I did tons of research. I think I researched for like 18 months, and I started looking outside of the United States. I didn't want to, train outside of the U.S., but
That's amazing. Perception is cool. We have the best medicine, but clearly we don't in this area.
I just wasn't happy with what I saw. I saw a lot of blue and green scalps, typical of tattooing. We don't want that.
Right.
I
don't want a blue scalp.
Yeah, we didn't want to have that result. It had to be something better.
It goes with my shirt, but if I'm not wearing blue, then it's a problem. Yes.
So this woman from Italy, she has a huge company called Beauty Medical, and she teaches hair surgeons all around the globe. It just so happened that the U.S. and Canadian trainer was not in operation. So this particular woman is the one who goes to teach hair surgeons. Anyone else on her team teaches estheticians and other people like myself. But that section of the business happened to be down at the time I was looking. So I got her. I got the top girl. So we brought her in from Italy here. Top woman. Yeah, top woman.
I was very
fortunate, though. She really, really is. She was, she was incredible. We learned a fabulous technique. And to this day, we're having a fabulous success with it because people are able to, do as we talked about. They're able to conceal these scars. The one biggest thing is supplemental hair follicles or, pigment we're placing in between these freshly transplanted hairs so that it gives the appearance of density. So you may be a hair transplant client where your transplants didn't work for you and you have run out of donor sites and you're using topics or a hair follicle.
No one likes you. No one loves you. Come to Dermographics.
And, we can help these people. We can help them conceal the scars. And of course, it works for women. It's astounding the number of women who have hair loss, and they're not candidates for hair transplants, many of them. And they certainly can't, they can wear wigs, but, it's incredibly uncomfortable. So, again, supplemental density pigmentation will really give them the look that they need.
And no one else does this in the United States, literally, or very few?
Trichopigmentation is being done in the United States by hair surgeons only.
Right.
There are very few people who are doing what I do. And I think in the last year, the statistics were I was the only permanent makeup technician doing trico.
Wow.
So it may have changed since then, but even if it's changed, I can't imagine it's more than a dozen across the United States, the continental
That's
United
remarkable.
States.
So. You would think that there'll be, with technology and communication that people would pick up on this.
It's getting here, but, we're kind of inundated by a couple of national brands that are doing scalp tattooing.
Uh-huh.
So it's different. There's a lot of that going on, but there's not a lot of what we're doing. So, and I think the consumer isn't sure which is which. So that's why we, educate them the difference. Our technique is not permanent. So, if a gentleman comes in and he's 30 years of age, dark brown hair, he's not going to look like that at 60.
No.
So why would we want a tattoo?
Permanent brown hair.
Permanent brown in a youthful hairline that's going to look very, very fake. So this is something that can be altered as he ages. So every 2 years, people would need to sort of, touch this up approximately.
And this is basically just going for one session or a couple sessions, I guess?
Initially, it's almost as long as a hair transplant.
Which is, how long is that?
I can work on somebody for three different, the initial first application could be broken up into 2 to 3 visits, mm-hmm. totaling up to 15 hours.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And you're so.
It may not be that long, but we're talking about it's the size of the area. A strip scar may be, maybe 3 hours total over several visits. But.
So you're spending 3 hours at a shot doing this work.
I've done longer five, six hour sessions.
And how do you stay awake when you're doing this? Do you ever nod off in the middle?
Once I get in my rhythm, it's an incredible focus.
Right, I bet.
It's
you falling asleep. That wouldn't be a good thing.
Yeah, it's definitely not falling asleep. It's challenging for me.
Cool. So we're almost out of time. We've been talking with Valerie Weber, who's really one of a kind, clearly, that you have this niche with this trigma. I'll let you pronounce it.
Trichopigmentation.
Yes, that too. And you've developed that whole specialty, but clearly it's much more than that. It's for people who really have had, across the board, just issues that there are now solutions to dealing cosmetically, that rather than have to walk around with this eyesore, so to speak.
It's debilitating for some people.
Right.
You know, and not only is it for people with hair transplant, it's for people who have alopecia. I've worked with several candidates, male and female. Alopecia areata is not full hair loss. It's patches.
Ooh.
So, you know, if you could imagine, you know, 10, 12 circular patches at random on the scalp that are just not growing hair. So a lot of the men will shave the hair down.
Right.
And I can go in and create supplements in that area that totally blend, and you can't tell the difference.
Amazing, Valerie. Not just you, but the team of Dermographics. Let's give them their just due.
I know. Absolutely.
And we know you do an outstanding job, but it's not just you.
No, absolutely. We have other technicians. And our goal is, you know, just to really be, we all kind of just want to be the best at what we can be. So my staff, they're highly educated. Everybody gets continuing education. I think I myself have said 72. I myself had 72 hours of continuing ed this past year. And everybody gets OSHA training. And yeah, we spend a lot of time.
40 hours a week adds up. That's cool. So most importantly, as we wrap up here, you're located in Doylestown, Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm. Right in the borough.
In the borough. Mm-hmm. So in the hood. So it's a rough day, but you don't have to pack. You know, it's a gun-free zone, so we're good there. And do you have a website as well?
Absolutely.
So you want to share that with the listeners?
Sure, it's dermographics.net. It's dermagraphics.net.
.net. Valerie, what a pleasure. I hope you enjoyed it, because I did.
I absolutely did.
And you gave me an education, which is, well, actually it's pretty easy because my knowledge is limited, but I've really been delighted to have you on, and I really appreciate what you do, and keep...
Thank you. It's definitely been a pleasure. I'm so happy to be here. I really am. I'm so glad we got a chance to go over all of these wonderful things.
Right, and it was a lot worse than what you expected, I guess. Is that the deal?
The Botox part was probably the worst.
The worst, yes. Yeah. Clearly for me. I learned my lesson. I can't... Valerie had a guide of topics, and I went off topic, and she really chopped me down to size for doing that. So I've learned my lesson. Anyway, so Valerie, it's been a pleasure. This is not just a one and done. We're bringing you back.
I would love to.
Yes. You've been appointed the medical reporter for Greenberg News. It's a responsibility. So.
I'll wear my lab coat next time.
Yeah, and I want that. And leave the Botox needles at home.
Okay.
Because I don't want to see any you or them together. I've learned that. So, and with that wraps up this segment of Greenberg News. We're going to take a brief break. Be right back after these messages.